example, okay, we have this identity matrix. Okay, what is the identity matrix? The identity matrix. Okay, for example, we have identity matrix size 2 by 2 and 1 0 0 1. Okay, this identity matrix, and then also 3 by 3. We have 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, identity matrix. We have the main diagonal equal to 1. Lah. Kat sini kan main diagonal dia. For example, we have this elementary matrix. Okay, identity matrix convert to elementary matrix. Okay, by using a single ERO. Single ERO. One operation of elementary row. Lah. Okay, for example, we have 1 0 0 1. Okay, transform into elementary matrix. Okay, we use a single operation, 2 R1. Transform into R1. So we get elementary matrix 0 2 0 0 1. Okay, this is elementary matrix by using single operation 2 row 1. Transform into row 1. Okay. Okay, let's look at another example. Okay, you all are there. Okay, which matrix are the elementary matrix? Okay, for example, number one, we have one, zero, 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 two, zero, 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 one. Is this elementary matrix?
No.
Elementary matrix tak? Apa syarat untuk elementary matrix? Okay, elementary matrix ni. Identity to elementary matrix. By using a single ERO and single ERO. One elementary row operation. By using single elementary row operation. Okay, so. Okay, untuk proof kan ni, you all kena buat lah. Untuk ni kan? Okay, from identity to elementary. So this is this contoh ni elementary, for example elementary 1. Kita nak proofkan the elementary or not kan? So we transform from identity to elementary. Is it using single operation, elementary row operation? So you all kena proof lah. So for example we have, okay this one. So identity matrix is 3 by 3 kan? 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, transform into this elementary matrix. I all check. So we use 2 row 2 kan? 2 row 2. Transform into row 2. Okay, so we get this elementary matrix. 1 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 1. So this one E1 is elementary matrix. The elementary matrix. Because there's one operation kat sini. One operation. One single operation. Single elementary row operation lah. One elementary row operation. Sebab dia ada satu je. Dia boleh buatkan satu je operation untuk convertkan daripada identity ke elementary. Dia ada satu je operation. So we call this is, we call this elementary matrix lah. E ni. Okay, boleh? Okay, another example. Okay, is this elementary matrix?
No.
No.
Elementary matrix?
No. No.
No.
Because?
Ada lebih daripada satu.
Ada lebih daripada satu operation kan? Okay, contoh kat sini cuba you all transform kan? Okay, ni untuk transform kepada ni kita menggunakan dua lebih daripada satu lah operation kan? Okay, so apa? Five row two negative five row two plus row one kan? Convert into, transform into row one. So we get 1, negative 5, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And then we have to make this third row ni 2 kan?
2R3.
So 2R3. R3. 2, 1, negative 5, 0. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2. So kat sini ada dua operation kan? 1, 2. So dia bukan lah. Dia bukan not elementary matrix. Because involve two operation. Boleh? Faham? Dia ada dua operation. 1, 2. Okay, ada soalan? Okay, kita tengok contoh yang ketiga.
Madam, madam.
Ya? Yeah.
Ada student tak masuk lagi.
Boleh join je lah. Saya buka je. Dah. Okay. Contoh yang ketiga. Okay, is it elementary matrix?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes,
madam.
Yes.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes, sebab satu.
Yes.
Yes ke?
No, ma'am.
Cuba you all check. From identity to this matrix. From identity to this matrix. Is it using single elementary row operation? Or more than one? More than one. Nampak macam elementary kan? Okay, cuba you all check ni E3 ni. Cuba check. Okay, check lah. One, zero, zero, one. Okay, ni we make two. So, two. Two row one plus row two. Row two. One, zero, two, one, and. Betul lah. So elementary matrix by using a single operation. Okay, contoh lagi. Okay, untuk yang ni. Is it elementary matrix?
No.
No.
No, kan? Because more than one operation.
One.
Ya, yeah, check lah. 1, 0, 0, 1.
No.
Row 1, row 1, 3, 0, 0, 1. Okay, untuk ni, convert kepada ni. So, boleh gunakan apa? 4/3 row 1 kan? Plus row 2. Row 2. Saya akan dapat 3, 0, 4, 1. Involve 2 operation. 2 elementary row operation. So not elementary matrix. Okay, faham semua elementary matrix?
Faham dia.
Faham dia.
Okay. So kita tengok next. Okay, next. Okay, representing the elementary row operation. Okay, from identity to elementary matrix, we use a single operation, elementary row operation. Okay, so what is the relationship between E? Okay, E is elementary matrix, A and B. Matrix A and matrix B. Okay, E ni elementary. Eh? Simbol untuk elementary matrix E. Eh? Walaupun dia tak, kalau dia tak mention kan. So ni, awak kena tahulah E is elementary. Elementary. Okay, if the same elementary row operation is performed on n, m times n matrix A, then the resulting matrix is given by the product E times A. Okay, so we transform A from A to matrix B by using elementary row operation. Then the product of E times A equal to B. Okay, for example, okay, this one. We have, okay, let matrix A equal to 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, and we have elementary matrix 2, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this is elementary matrix. Elementary matrix, okay. Using operation, okay, we get this elementary matrix using operation 2 row 1 transform into row 1 kan, untuk ni, using this operation. So we get elementary matrix. Then, okay, A equal to 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, we use the same operation with this elementary matrix 2 row 1 transform into row 1. Then we get another matrix B. 4, 8, negative 1, 3 equal to B, matrix B. Then we check A times A, okay, equal to B or not. Therefore, A times A equal to B. A times A equal to B, okay, because we transform from A to B, also use the same elementary operation with elementary matrix. Then, okay, ni kalau dia melibatkan one operation je lah kes ni. Okay, contohnya okay, contoh cepat, ada tak tutup mic awak eh? Dengar tak clear? Suara saya clear tak?
Clear,
madam. Yeah. Clear, madam. Tak tutup mic awak. Keluar, dengar macam tak clear. Okay, contohnya. Okay, we have 1 times 3 by 3. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 4. 2, positive 1, and negative 1. Then we have elementary matrix. Go to 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. So you all check. Is it E? A, E times A equal to B or not? Okay, check. Né? E times A equal to B or not? Okay, first we transform from identity to elementary matrix by using a single operation. Okay, untuk ni. First, from identity, KE, okay, equal to from identity, to this elementary matrix, this elementary matrix. So we use operation, transform from identity to elementary matrix, we use what operation?
2R1.
Plus
N. Interchange the row.
We interchange the row and row 1 with row 3 and row 1 interchange with row 3 to get this elementary matrix. From identity to elementary matrix. So we interchange 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. 1, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is elementary matrix by using single operation, row 1 interchange with row 3. And then, okay, from A to B. Okay, A to B. Okay, we use this operation, row 1 interchange with row 3. So A tadi, interchange lah. So I can dapat B and B apa? Interchange from A to B. Interchange row kan. So terbalikkan lah. Kena dapat 2, 1, negative 1, 0, 1, 4, 1, 2, 3. A to B. Kat sini A to B. So interchange row 1. Row 1 to row 3. Then we get B lah. So I'll prove kan. E times A equal to B or not? Okay, cuba darabkan. Zero, zero. Kita balik. Okay, A, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 4, 2, 1, 8, 1. Okay, dapat equal to B kan? 2, check. One. Negative one. Let's take a row. Zero. One. Four. The next. One. Two. Three. Saya dapat sama. E times A equal to B. Okay. Okay, ada soalan?
Ada, madam.
Tak ada.
Tak ada, madam.
Okay. Dekat another example. Okay, how to determine the size of an elementary matrix? Okay, in case one, if A is a square matrix. For example, we have A matrix size 2 by 2. Kat sini kan, 2 by 2. Matrix size for A, 2 by 2, 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, then E times A equal to B. So, we use elementary matrix size 2 by 2 lah untuk dapatkan ni. 2 by 2 times 2 by 2, we get 2 by 2 matrix. B size 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, yang ni tak ada masalah kan? Ni biasa square matrix. Okay, case 2, if A, ni case 2 lah, if A is not a square matrix. A ni not a square matrix. Okay, kita tengok sini. A size 2 by 3. A size 2 by 3. Okay, then B also size 2 by 3 lah. Dia mesti size yang sama kan? 2 by 3. Okay, in order to get this equation, we have to multiply with elementary matrix size 2 by 2. Boleh? Untuk 2 by 2, so we get E times A equal to B. Ini 2 by 2. Faham tak ni? Ni kita check multiplication lah in chapter 1. Multiplication of two matrix. So 2 by 2 multiple with matrix size 2 by 3. Then we get matrix size B 2 by 3. Matrix B size 2 by 3.
Madam.
Ya.
Yeah? Ada student yang tak dapat masuk lagi.
Kenapa ni? Itulah. Boleh? Boleh tak masuk ni? Tak ada pun masuk. Siapa tak dapat masuk? Tak ada pun masuk. Boleh je. Ataupun you all klik dekat you future, nanti dia automatic dia terus dapat masuk. You future gunakan you all punya student ID kan. Ha, terus dia dapat masuk. Link ada dalam you future, siapa yang dapat masuk tu. Okay, untuk yang ni. Okay, ni contoh if A is not a square matrix. Okay, contoh sekarang saya bagi A is, okay ni A is 3 by 2 by 3. If A is given 3 by 2. So what is the size of elementary matrix? Kat sini. If the size of A 3 by 2 and also B 3 by 2. So what is the size of this elementary matrix?
2 by 3.
Apa? Ini. If A
3 by 3, madam.
3 by 3 kan? Okay, if A, okay, A equal to matrix size, yeah. Contohlah ada 3 by 2. 3 by 2, 2, 1, 0, 2, 0, 1. 3 by 2. Now B also 3 by 2. So it's the size of this element 3?
3 by 3.
Dia mesti 3 by 3 lah kan? So E times A equal to B kan? So kat sini B 3 by 2. Okay, A 3 by 2. So kat sini mesti 3 by 3 lah. Matrix, elementary matrix mesti 3 by 3. So kalau ni kita untuk check dia punya multiplication kan, dia mesti the number of column for matrix A equal to number of row for the number of column for matrix E equal to number of row for matrix A kat sini, 3. So mesti elementary dia 3 by 3. Boleh? Untuk ni, case 2 ni. Case 2 ni dia ada sikit, itulah. Okay, contoh lagi saya kalau saya bagi, if A equal to two by four, B 2 by 4. So what is the size of elementary matrix E?
2 by 2.
E is 2 by 2. Boleh eh? Check ni lah. Check dia punya ni kan. E times A equal to B. So kat sini dapat lah E 2 by 2 lah kan. 2 by 2. Okay, multiple with A. 2 by 4. Then we get B equal to 2 by 4. Tu dah sama kan, 2 2. So you get 2 by 4. Okay. Okay then, okay next is row equivalent. Okay, row equivalent, B is, okay the symbol of row equivalent, B equivalent to A lah, B is row equivalent to A. A and B are square matrix. If there exists a finite number of elementary matrix E1, E2, E3 until EK, okay, such that B equal to okay, EK times EK minus 1 times E2 times E1 times A. Untuk ni, we have a finite number of elementary matrix. To reduce from A to B, to reduce A to B, we have a we have more than one operation. Okay, for example, okay, this example, we reduce from A to B and we have two operation. One operation, second operation. Then we have two elementary matrix. First elementary matrix and this one is second elementary matrix. Nah, ni terbalik pula macam yang tadi kita ada, kita nak reduce, nak dapat A to B kita guna single operation kan, based on elementary matrix. Untuk yang ni kita reduce A to B, tengok ada berapa operation, then dari situ kita dapatlah berapa elementary matrix. Okay, contoh ni kan, from A to B. Okay, we have A equal to 2, 4, negative 1, 3. And then B equal to 7, negative 1, negative 1, 3. Okay, to reduce A from A to B, we have two operation. Okay, first operation, 2R1 and 2R1 transform into R1. And then second operation, okay, negative 3R2 plus R1 transform into R1. Okay, so in this we have two elementary matrix. For elementary 1, Okay, we use first operation 2R1 transforming 2R1. So from identity to elementary matrix using first operation 2R1. So we get first elementary matrix at 2001. And then second elementary matrix, we use second operation. Negative 3R2 plus R1. Transforming to R1. So dah akan dapat ni lah, elementary matrix is 1, negative 3, 0, 1. Okay, and then kat sini boleh check. Check guna yang ni. V equal to okay, is it E2 times, okay, we check using this ni lah, this theorem kan, covalent. Check. This equivalent theorem, B equivalent to A. Okay, is it B equivalent to A? So we check E2 times E1 times A equal to B or not? So E2 tadi dapat kan? E2, 1, negative 3, 0, 1. Then multiple with E1, 2, 0, 0, 1. Okay, multiple with A. A is, okay, this metric, 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, equal to B or not? So equal to B. Therefore, A is, B is row equivalent to A. Tengok ni. Ya, check. So ni kita check akan dapat sama lah. So B is equivalent to A. Okay, yang ni. Contoh dia. Okay, contoh dekat sini. Contoh lain. Okay, we have matrix size A 3x3. And then we have B equal to okay, transform A to B. Apa? A to B. Transform A. Transform into B. Okay, cuba transform. From A to B. Okay, we make leading one and B is leading one, 1, 2, 3. See. So 1/2 row 1. So 1, 2, 3, 0, -1, 3, 3, 6, 10. Then we make this 3 equal to 0 and tengok, based on matrix B lah. So we use operation Negative 3 row 1 plus row 3. One, two, three, zero, negative one, three, zero, zero, Okay, lagi apa? Kat sini. Lagi.
Negative R2.
Berapa siapa?
Negative R2.
Negative R2 kan ni dah jadikan 1, negative 3. So, negative R2. R2. 1, 2, 3. 0, 1. Negative 3. 0, 0, 1. So in this example, we have three operation. So we have three, we can have three elementary matrix. First operation, second operation, third operation. So we can have three elementary matrix. Okay, so first elementary matrix E1 dia apa? 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, using first operation 1 over 2 row 1. First operation ni. First operation. So we get elementary matrix 1 over 2, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, that second. Second elementary matrix. Ini kan, second operation. 1, 0, 0. Negative 3 row 1 plus row 3. Plus 2 row 3. So, I dapat 1 0 0 0 1 0. Okay, negative 3 0 1. Okay, this is okay, this is E1, this is E2. Okay, E3. Okay, using third operation, negative row 2. Row 2 je. 1, 0, 0, 0, negative 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Ini E3. Okay, then you all check. So using this theorem, E2, this theorem, man. So is it E3 times E2 times E1 times A equal to B or not? Ya, kena darab lah. Tiga kan. Okay, check. So, it is proof lah. A is row equivalent to matrix B. Okay, boleh. Ya, darabkan. So, E3, 1, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0.
Ya.
Yeah.
Ya. Yang U3 times E2 times E1 times A tu boleh tekan kereta tu.
Apa?
Mana? Calculator ke? Kalkulator darab tu.
Oh, boleh?
Boleh tekan.
Tekan, masukkan calculator je.
Okay, madam.
Boleh gunakan calculator eh. Terus dia tekan. Untuk check dia apa ni. Penting awak punya calculation nak tunjukkan lah. E2, how to get E2, E1, E2, E3. Ni, operation ni. E1, E2, E3. And then, proof. E1. Betul B times A. Ni banyak kan dia punya, kalau nak buat satu-satu boleh terus guna calculator lah. Two, four, six, zero, three, one. Equal to B. Okay. Okay, this is row equivalent.
Madam.
Yeah.
Kalau yang second operation tu, ke tukangan third operation. Contoh macam kita buat yang negatif R2 dulu, baru negatif R1 plus R3.
Boleh?
Boleh ke madam? Sama ke madam?
Boleh. Sama je. Boleh. Jadi maksudnya itu awak nanti terbalik dengan E3 kan? Boleh. Ya cubalah check. Dia tak kisah. Yang mana based on awak punya ni, kadang-kadang contohlah ni awak boleh dapat 3 operation, kadang-kadang ada yang dapat 4 operation. Yang penting awak punya operation tu betul, dan untuk elementary pun operation tu betul lah. Untuk dapatkan elementary dia, baru dia akan proofkan untuk teorem ni. Baru jawapan dia akan betul lah untuk teorem ni. Okay, ada lagi soalan? Ni. Tak ada. Awak boleh tekan calculator lah untuk multiply ni. For matrix ni kan. Tak ada. Semua faham? Untuk ni. So B is equivalent to matrix A. Okay, tak ada soalan kan?
Tak ada man.
Okay, nak tunjuk contoh lagi ke? Contoh nanti awak boleh cuba buat. Lepas ni, kalau habis awal tu awak boleh cuba buat ni soalan pasti kan? Ada yang nak saya tunjuk contoh lagi? Row for row equivalent, B is equivalent to A. Tak ada. So next, okay, elementary matrix versus inverse elementary matrix. Elementary matrix versus inverse of elementary matrix. Okay. First column is elementary row operation for elementary matrix. The elementary row operation. And then second column is the inverse of elementary row operation. E inverse. Okay, so the first step there, interchange row and row I interchange with RJ. So the operation for inverse elementary matrix also same with ni elementary row operation. Kita gunakan operation yang sama lah untuk dapatkan E. Untuk dapatkan E inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, for second step, multiple with non-zero constant KRI transform into RI sepatutnya ni. RI. Okay, for second step, KRI. Okay, to get the inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, we use operation 1 over K, RI. Transform into RI. Nah, dia akan jadi 1 over K. Yang tadi untuk elementary, awak gunakan operation K kan? K times row, whatever row. K times, for example, row 2. Transform into row 2. Okay, for inverse, we use 1 over. Contohnya, awak guna 2 kan? 1 over 2. We get 1 over 2. Kita dapatkan inverse elementary matrix. Dia yang berubah 2 ni. Second and third. Okay, third ni. Okay, RI plus KRJ. Transform into RI. Tapi biasanya ni kita gunakan sebelum ni KRJ kan. Plus RI kan. Transform into RI. Contoh sebelum ni kita biasa gunakan contoh 3 row 2 plus 3R2 plus R3 transform into R3 kan. Contohlah kat sini. So untuk dapatkan inverse of elementary matrix, dia akan jadi yang ni negative K yang kat sini. So sini dia akan jadi negative 3 lah. So to get the inverse of elementary matrix, okay, we use operation ni, negative 3 R2 plus R3 transform into R3. Boleh, ni contoh ni. Boleh ni. Contoh dia kat sini lagi. So yang berubah ada dua operation ni lah. KRI dengan ni. Third operation. Okay, for example, we have this elementary matrix. Okay, identity to elementary matrix. This one elementary matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, to get the elementary matrix 0, 1, 1, 0. So, untuk dapatkan inverse, we use operation apa? For this example. Example A ni. Untuk ni. Dia akan gunakan operation yang sama lah kan. Kita change row untuk yang ni. Dia akan dapat E negative 1 equal to E in elementary inverse equal to akan dapat yang sama lah. From ni juga 1 0 0 1. We use same operation. Row 1 interchange with row 2. So we get same lah, same 0, 1, 1, 0. E inverse same with elementary matrix. Okay, second example B. Okay, the elementary operation Elementary matrix, we use operation 2R1 transform into R1 kan, untuk ni. So we get elementary matrix 2001. So to get the inverse of this elementary matrix, okay, we use operation 1/2. Dia akan jadi 1/2. Kat sini 2 ni dia akan jadi 1/2 inverse. So we use 1/2 row 1, translate into row 1 lah. Dia akan dapat apa? Matrix eh. So ni 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, we use operation ni lah kan. 1/2 row 1. Row 1. So awak akan dapat 1/2, 0, 0, 1. Okay, boleh? Third example. Let me see. Okay, this operation. Row 1. Tapi sebenarnya kita guna yang nak tambah yang second kan. Row 2 plus row 1 kan. Transform into row 1. Now this operation. So for inverse of elementary matrix, dia akan jadi negative eh. Negative row 2 plus row 1. Dia akan jadi negative kat sini. Ni akan jadi negative. Negative row 2 plus row 1. So akan dapat apa? E inverse equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, using operation negative kan. Dia akan jadi negative yang depan dia ni. Negative row 2 plus row 1. So akan dapat negative row 2 plus row 1. 1, negative 1. 0, 1. Boleh? Ni untuk inverse of elementary matrix lah. Contoh lagi yang ni. Ni melibatkan dua lah sebab more than one operation kan, from A to B. Ni yang tadi, ni yang untuk row equivalent. A ni row equivalent, ni row equivalent. Matrix A equivalent to B on it ni. Untuk A equivalent to B. Untuk check yang ni lah. Okay, faham tak yang ni? Tengok contoh lain lah. Contoh kat sini. Okay, contoh yang ni. Okay, example we have. Okay, elementary matrix. We have E1 equal to 1, 0, 0, 3. Okay, so I'll cari ni eh, dia punya ni. Cari E1 inverse. Apa dia? E2 to find E2 inverse. E3. Find E3 inverse. Okay, cuba saya sekarang. Okay, ni saya tanya. Okay, siapa ni? Okay, untuk awak punya ni, nama awak dalam ni awak boleh tak? Okay, bubuh nama penuh. Nama penuh, nama penuh awak. Dengan kelas eh, sekali. Contohnya macam ni lah. Awak bubuh, letak kelas lah dulu. Kelas and nama awak. CS248184, siapa nama? Nama tak payah nama ayah tak apa, tapi nama full awak lah. Contoh ni CS249 1A2. Nama penuh siapa? Nur Farahin Eliana. Dia tak macam tu je. Saibatul Asmalia. Kelas and nama. Untuk ni eh. So nanti final awak pun final awak pun awak save dalam kelas and nama lah awak punya jawapan. Okay, saya tanya ni. Radiatul Mardia. Kelas apa ni? Radiatul Mardia. CS248184. Radiatul Mardia. Okay, dapat apa? E1 inverse. Radiatul Mardia. Radiatul Mardia ada tak? Radiatul Mardia. Kalau ada problem awak punya mic, boleh tulis dalam chat eh. Siti Nur Kamarina.
Hey, madam.
Okay, jawapan untuk E1 inverse apa?
0103. Eh, salah. 0310.
3, kita gunakan operation apa untuk yang ni? 3 3 row 2 kan? 3 row 2 2 row 2. So dia akan dapat E1 inverse dapat apa? Apa tadi awak dapat?
0310.
0310. Okay, ni awak gunakan operation apa? First awak kena identify dulu operation dia. Yep.
Oh, okay.
Ni salah, awak kena first identify dulu operation dia. Operation untuk E1 ni. To get E1 from identity to E1. Gunakan operation apa? 1, identity to 1 kan? Eh? Identity to E1, 1 0 0 1. Untuk dapatkan E1 ni, kita guna operation apa? 3 row 2 kan? 2 row 2. Boleh? Siapa? Tadi siapa nama?
Boleh.
Kamarina?
Boleh.
Okay, kita gunakan operation ni kan? Okay, jadi untuk dapatkan okay, ni awak akan dapat E1 lah, 1003. Okay, untuk dapatkan E1 inverse guna operation apa? E1 inverse ni, E1 lah. E1.
Okay, R2.
Okey, guna apa?
One over three.
Ah, guna yang kedua lah. Dia akan jadi one over three kan kat sini.
One over three to R2.
Dia akan dapat ni lah. Untuk ni, 1, 0, 0, 1. So, E1 inverse akan dapat 1, 0, 0, 1 over 3 lah sepatutnya. Yang ni untuk E1 inverse. Boleh? Ni E1 inverse.
Boleh, Adam. Thank you.
Okay. Faham eh?
Faham.
Okay, next. Okay, siapa ni? Nur Izzah Rohaida. Nur Izzah Rohaida. Nur Izzah? Tak ada ni ke kat depan ni? Nur Izzah ni ke mana ni? Nur Izzah. One A one eh? 249 1A1. Nurul Ilya. Ni siapa yang saya panggil tak ada nama ni ya? Saya tolak makan nama. Simon. Nurul Ilya.
Ya.
Okay, number two.
Number two. Nah, dia akan jadi negative two plus.
Okay, untuk ni operation kita guna apa? No, elementary matrix. Operation for elementary matrix.
2R2 plus R1.
Apa?
2R2 plus R1.
Dia negatif?
Negative 2R2 plus R1. Lepas tu, inverse dia, dia jadi, ya.
Okay, patient tu akan guna
negative 2R2 plus R1.
Negative 2R2 plus R1 kan?
Ya.
Itu E. E2 lah. Operation for E2. Okay, so E operation for E2 inverse?
Jadi R2 plus R1.
Jadi apa? Okay, tengok balik. Tengok balik ni. Tadi saya dah bagi tahu kan kat sini. Nah, tengok balik yang ni. So kat sini kita ikut yang ni lah kan. Ikutkan yang ada plus lah ni. Ha, tengok kita akan ubah yang dia akan jadi negatif. Negatif R2 ni. Dia operation ni positif kan. R2 plus R1. So yang inverse ni dia akan ubah yang depan ni lah. Simbol dia. Dia jadi negatif.
Okay, jadi R2 plus R1.
Jadi negatif. Dia akan jadi, tadi awak guna negatif kan. Dia akan jadi 2 plus R1. Inverse elementary matrix dia.
Inverse elementary matrix dia, dia akan jadi
yang mana yang tak yang tak ubah kita salin balik lah kan. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Akan jadi apa? Sini 1 akan jadi?
one. Yang tu akan jadi two.
Two.
Zero.
Okay, good. Kita jadi jadi lah untuk E2 inverse.
Okay.
Boleh. E1 tadi yang ni lah. E1 daripada soalan lah 1 negative 2. 0, 0, 1, 0. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Next E3. Ada volunteer nak jawab? Tak. Ilya ni. Ilya ni tengok. Jangan lupa tick your feature ya. Kalau tak tick eh tu kan. Okay, next ada ada volunteer nak jawab untuk untuk E3.
Saya.
Mem.
Ashura. Okay, ya? Yeah?
Mem.
Ya? Yeah?
Nak tanya kan? Yang E2 tu, E2 inverse tu kan?
Inverse, okay.
2R2 plus R1 tu jadi 2 tu macam mana ni?
Jadi 2 ni?
Ah.
Sebab kita ikut ni. Dia punya ni.
Daripada
ada yang sini kan. Kita akan gunakan operation yang ketiga ni lah kan. Ni negatif KR negatif K ya. KRJ plus RI transform into RI. Ataupun contohnya yang kat sini lah. Kalau awak dapat 3R2 plus R3 transform into R3. Okay, untuk inverse dia akan jadi negatif. Tiga ni dia akan jadi negatif. Simbol dia akan tukar negatif lah. Negatif 3R2 plus R3 transform into R3. Yang ni dia akan jadi negatif. Nampak yang ni positif kan? Operation positif kan? 3R2 kan? Untuk inverse dia akan jadi negatif. Negatif 3R2 ni.
Okay.
Untuk ni 3. So ni jadi negatif 3. So yang tadi ni untuk yang ni contoh ni itu untuk dapatkan itu awak gunakan operation untuk dapat itu yang ni kan. Kita akan gunakan operation negatif 2R2 plus R1 kan. Untuk dapatkan itu. So untuk dapatkan E2 inverse dia akan ubah lah. Yang ni dia akan jadi negatif tu ni dia akan jadi positif lah.
Okay,
dia akan jadi positif. Itu.
Okay.
Ashura tadi nak jawab kan? Untuk E3? Gunakan operation apa?
Lima R3 tambah R1.
Okay, 5R3 tambah R1. R1 kan? Ni untuk dapatkan E3 kan?
E3.
Dapat E3 lah kan? 1, 0, 5 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So untuk dapatkan E3 inverse?
Negative 5 R3 tambah R1.
Dia akan jadi negative 5 R3 tambah R1. Okay, so akan dapat
10 negative 5 0 1 0 0 1.
Ni daripada identiti dia daripada identiti lah kan? Identiti daripada sini kan? Daripada identiti lah. So akan dapat apa?
10 negatif 5 0 1 0 0 0 1.
So ni adalah E3 inverse. Ni awak punya E3. Okay. Faham? Yang lain faham? Thank you. Okay, good. Okay, yang lain boleh?
Boleh. Make sure jangan tersalah lah dia punya simbol ke apa kan untuk operation dia ni. So yang kita akan ubah hanya untuk dua operation yang yang kedua lah, yang kedua dan ketiga, operation yang kedua dan ketiga, operation kedua yang ni kan. Multiple with non zero constant. Dia akan jadi 1 over k. Untuk yang ketiga, akan ubah dia punya simbol. Simbol yang depan ni. Okay, next. Okay, the inverse elementary matrix. Okay, yang tadilah. Okay, so untuk proof kan. Okay, ni proof. So proof for inverse A equal to E1 inverse multiple with E2 inverse multiple with E3 inverse times I equal to A. So kat sini untuk dapatkan A inverse lah. Sebelum ni kita untuk dapatkan A inverse we use elementary row operation kan. A untuk sebelum ni system of ni system of linear equation lah. Akan gunakan untuk dapat A inverse, ingat tak sebenarnya? A inverse akan gunakan A equal to I yang identity kan. So nanti okay, kita tukar akan dapat I equal to A inverse. Okay ni first method. Okay second method kita boleh gunakan elementary matrix ni. So A inverse equal to ni. E3 times E2 times E1 equal to A inverse. Boleh? Second method boleh gunakan ni. A inverse equal to guna elementary, the concept of elementary matrix lah. E3 times E2 times E1 equal to A inverse. Okay, contoh dia yang ni lah. A equal to, okay ni kita nak proof balik. Proof balik original matrix dia kan. A equal to E1 inverse multiple with E2 inverse multiple with I identity. Then we get matrix A. So we want to get A inverse. So A inverse equal to E2 times E1. So akan dapat A inverse. Ini using elementary matrix. Second method lah. First method awak gunakan untuk ni 2 by 2 A inverse awak boleh gunakan formula kan. Sama ada formula kan untuk cari A inverse. So boleh guna formula kan. 1 over AD minus BC kan. AD 2 minus 0 kan. Yang sebelum ni. 1, 2, 84. 0 kan. So akan dapat 1 over 2 negative 2 0 1 kan. Ni guna formula yang sebelum ni yang kita belajar. So ni guna elementary, the concept of elementary matrix. E2 times E1 equal to A inverse. Okay. Okay, so dah habis lah untuk yang ni. Property of. So ni summary ya. Okay, ada soalan tak untuk ni? Yang ni awak kena ingat lah ni. Dia punya ni. Proof punya ni. So untuk dapat A inverse awak kena ingat. E3 times, ingat E3 times E2 times E1 ikut A inverse. To get, to prove A, A equal to E1 inverse times E2 inverse times E3 inverse. Okay, yang ni susunan dia kena betul eh. Dia kena, awak kena darabkan E3 times E2 times E1. Kalau ni awak susunan awak terbalik, awak akan dapat salah. Ni, kalau susunan awak terbalik kan, contoh A1 inverse awak dapat, awak terbalikkan. E1 times E2 times E3. Awak akan dapat salah lah jawapan dia. Susunan dia ni, menurun. Itu E3 times itu times E1. Kena take note lah yang untuk yang ni. Susunan untuk yang ni. Dengan dengan yang atas ni sama. Dua ni susunan dia. Okay, so summary. Okay, the property of invertible matrix. Okay, each elementary matrix E is invertible and the inverse matrix E inverse is also an elementary matrix. Okay, invertible kita dah tengok sebelum ni kan. Invertible is determinant is not equal to zero. Invertible. Determinant of E is not equal to zero. Okay, then a square matrix A is invertible if and only if can be written as a product of elementary matrix. This product of elementary matrix, A equal to inverse times E1 inverse times E2 inverse times E3 inverse. This is the product of elementary matrix. Okay, then, okay, summary for equivalent condition. Okay, if A is a square matrix, N times N, can the following statement are equivalent? Okay, A is invertible. Okay, ni dia punya summary lah. If A is N times N, then A is invertible. A times B, A times X equal to B has unique solution for every N times 1 column matrix B. Okay, ni we have unique solution lah. If A is immutable. Okay, number 3 is for homogeneous system of linear equation. AX equal to 0, dia untuk homogeneous. Homogeneous. Homogeneous system of linear equation. Okay, has only trivial solution. So maksudnya trivial solution ni, solution for X. X all X equal to 0 kan? All X equal to 0. Trivial solution. Okay, number 4. Okay, A is row equivalent to identity matrix. And number 5. Okay, A can be written as product of elementary matrix. Ha, ni yang tadilah A. A equal to E1 inverse multiple with E2 inverse triple with nanti E and inverse. So ni summary ya. Summary for all chapter 2. So kita dah habis belajar lah untuk chapter 2 ni. Okay, summary. Okay, by using. Okay, summary number 1. By using method of Gauss-Jordan elimination, the system of linear equation need to be reduced to RREM. Ni semua tahu kan? RREM kan? So, Gauss-Jordan RREM. Okay, second, by using Gaussian elimination method, okay, the linear system of linear equation need to be reduced into REM, row epsilon matrix, REM. Okay, there are 3 types of solution. Okay, unique solution, infinite solution, and no solution. Okay, so untuk no solution ni dia inconsistent lah. For consistent, dia ada many solution and unique solution, 2. And then number 4. Homogeneous is always consistent and has 2 types of solution. Trivial and non-trivial solution. Homogeneous ni. Homogeneous always consistent lah. Maksudnya dia tak ada no solution lah. Dia mesti ada solution untuk homogeneous. Okay, number 5. Elementary matrix. Square matrix is obtained by a single operation on identity matrix. Okay, ni tadi definition of elementary matrix kan. Okay, number 6. The size of elementary matrix depend on the number of row of matrix A if E times A equal to B. Ha, ni yang check tadi lah. Yang saya so check kan, the size of A, size of B, matrix B and matrix E. Okay, 7, the inverse of elementary matrix is obtained by the inverse operation of elementary row operation. Yang tadi last. Yang last lah untuk ni. Okay, and then if A and B are row equivalent, hence B equal to E time EK times EK minus 1 times E2 times E1 times A. Ha, ni yang tadi lah kan yang awak dapatnya ni. Kita proofkan tadi. E2 times E1 times A equal to B. Okay, ni matrix A can be written as a product of elementary matrix. Saya tunjuk yang last tadi tu. A equal to E1 inverse. Susunan dia masih sama kan ni. E2 inverse times E3 inverse. And then, okay, last, the inverse of A can be obtained from the multiplication of elementary matrix. Another solution of system, another solution of inverse lah, inverse matrix. A inverse equal to E3 times E2 times E1. Okay. So, dah habislah untuk chapter ni. Chapter 2, the system of linear equation. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan? Ada apa soalan? Apa awal juga lagi ni. Okay, nak buat, you all buat tutorial lah sikit, soalan tutorial. Okay, cuba tengok ni. Okay, nampak tak? Soalan?
Nampak.
Nampak.
Okay, nampak. Okay, cuba buat ni. 1A ni. Elementary matrix. Cuba buat sekarang. Okay, saya tanya. Okay, consider B equal to matrix size 3 by 3. And I and given identity. Matrix. To find the elementary matrix E1, E2 such that E2 times E1 times B equal to I3. So this one you have to reduce. Okay, awak jangan confuse pula. Sebelum ni kan ada dia guna A, B kan. Ha, yang ni kita assume B ni A lah. B ni equal to A lah. We want to reduce B, reduce into I, identity. Sebenarnya ni A reduce into B kan. Untuk yang ni. So ni kan biasanya awak buat A. So, A reduce into B. Okay, untuk ni B, awak kena reduce to I3. And then number two, compute E1 inverse, E2 inverse. Okay, boleh cuba buat dulu kan? Jangan left dulu. Okay, you all punya attendance. Ha, make sure. Jangan lupalah dalam your future. And okay, saya akan bagi ni Google form. Nampak kan soalan tadi kan? Soalan nampak kan?
Nampak.
Nampak kan? Korang ni saya buat nak Google Form. Oh, nampak soalan kan? Still nampak soalan kan?
Nampak.
Nampak, madam.
Okay, buat eh. Thank you. Cuba awak try klik attendance boleh ke? Tak boleh. Boleh tak klik attendance? Tak boleh. Boleh tak?
Boleh, madam.
Boleh.
Boleh, boleh.
Boleh, okey. Okay, dah dapat dah? Jawapan? Okay, dah dapat jawapan?
Dah, madam. Dah.
Okay, apa jawapannya? B, A. Number one, find the elementary matrix E1 and E2. E1 and E2. E1 equal to? E1 berapa? Volunteer boleh jawab. Seorang volunteer. Reduce dapat berapa? Using operation negative 3R1 plus R2 kan?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, madam.
Yeah, madam.
And then second operation 1 over 5 RT. Okay, so akan dapat E1 dapat 1. Cek jawapannya 100 negative 3 1 0 0 1.
Sama.
Okay, itu akan dapat 100 010 0 0 1 over 5.
Sama.
Okay. Okay, B E1 inverse. Okay, tadi kita guna operation negative 3 row 1 plus row 2 kan. Untuk yeah. E1 inverse, operation dia?
3R1
plus R2. Okay, so akan dapat E1 inverse 1 0 0 3 1 0 0 0 1. Sama?
Sama.
Okay, untuk E2 inverse operation 5 row 3. So akan dapat 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 5. Okay. Okay, so dah habislah untuk ni. Okay, tutorial tu yang mana bukan dengan you all, bukan dengan saya kan. Tapi cuba buatlah tutorial tu. Jadi saya akan post lah juga jawapan. Rachel, tutorial awak macam mana? Handle tutorial awak. Macam mana? Kelas apa? Ada 3 kelas kan? CS2. Semua dengan sama ke? Lecture yang sama? Puan Hidayah. CS249 Senaja. You all buat online ke tak? Offline. Buat online ke offline tutorial? Apa? Amira?
Offline.
Offline.
Dekat GC.
Selalu apa?
Hantar dekat GC.
Hantar kat GC. Dia suruh buat dah tutorial tu?
Dah.
Dah. Okay, boleh siapkan semualah sampai elementary matrix kan?
Haa.
249 pun sama eh. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan last untuk ni?
Tak ada madam.
Tak ada eh. Okay, so thank you lah for your attention. Okay, see you next week. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.